Lies of the Third Temple, Part 72. I'm Professor Hannes Redlinghuis of the First Assembly of Yafashua in South Africa, Pretoria, Montana. Should you require any of the books which I've written, especially the book Israel's Rapture, very, very important, thick A5 book, which was my doctoral degree, please contact us at our WhatsApp number 0722-367-124. That's +27 international code, or just go to my website https://yahvah.co.za. If this is the first time that you will participate in the study, you are very, very welcome. But please go to part one, start from the beginning. You have missed quite a bit of information. Very important to subscribe to the channel in order to receive all the different notifications and also the TikTok messages. Very important, very, very important. Share these links with your friends and family. Make sure you have at least a 1611 King James Bible ready. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof Hannes. I trust that this study is going to be a blessing to you in the name of Yahshua, the name above every other name. The word said so. We were going to continue where we left off yesterday morning, and I'm going to continue with the discussion. But imagine what a game changer it would be if someone shows up with a plan that gave Israel a new temple on the Temple Mount. You can see why Israel will welcome such a proposal. Now this someone they see as Yahshua. Now, my question yesterday morning was at the end, what will Yahshua, if he has to return back to Jerusalem, what will he teach different? If there were a temple, a third or fourth temple, and he would sit in the temple, what would he teach different? There's not a scripture in the Bible that says Yahshua is going to come and sit in the third temple. There's not a scripture. The temple they refer to is either the temple which King Solomon built or the temple that Israel rebuilt after captivity and exile from Babylon. There's no other temple. There's no other temple. So the necessity for this temple, you see, is because the Israelites doesn't want to break square off with the laws, the 613 laws. They actually are insinuating that Yahshua will come and sit in the temple and again reinstate the 613 laws of Moses. Did he died in vain? 2,000 years ago, did he died in vain? Has he given his life for nothing? Just to come and do everything over again? Like I said yesterday morning at the end, Yahshua had a 3 years ministry. 2 years he only ministered to his nation, Israel and Judah. So what happened? The third year he turned the message of salvation through the sanctification blood. He turned it to the Gentiles. And ever since he's been ministering, the word of salvation went to the Gentiles. That's how we got saved. We were Gentiles. We are from the 10 northern tribes of Israel. Gentiles. Today I'm not a Gentile, I'm a Yahvist. Saved through the redemption blood of Yahshua. We glorify his name for giving his life so that we can live a life of holiness. But he has to reveal himself to Israel. There's not a scripture that says he's going to reveal himself to Israel again. Not a scripture. There's not one scripture that says he has to come and sit in the temple. the Pope, the Peacemaker, the Pontifex Maximus, the Vicar of Christ. He's going to sit in the temple, the first period. He's supposed to sit there for 7 years. The last week of Daniel, the 70th week of Daniel. But the Bible says after 1,230 days, not 60 days, 30 days, the covenant is going to be broken. The bride has been taken out. The Ruach HaKodesh is gone. Now starts a great tribulation. Yahushua is not going to sit in the temple for 3.5 years. Well, it's actually not 3.5 years. It's 41 months. It's not 42 months. Because if I deduct Daniel 12 verse 11, which is 1,290 days, if I deduct it from the 7 year period, which is 2,520 days, we'll find that the answer or the question mark that we have here is 1,230 days. 41 months, 43 months, 84 months. How easy is that? So Yahushua is not coming to sit in the temple to do what? To teach you. I mean, Israel has a history that they never even listened to their prophets. You take Jeremiah. Ezekiel, he prophesied to say that 23 years before Israel was exiled in the time of Babylon, he says they had to repent and they wouldn't. I mean, the Israelites never gave an ear to any of the teachings the prophets brought. Israel turned to idols. Now Yahushua need to come and sit in the temple to do what? To do sacrifice on behalf of Israel? And is he going to break the covenant? Because the same one that's sitting in the temple in the time of false peace, you know, false peace, because there's no war, they are. The one who's sitting there is offering on behalf of Israel. The war, or let me say, the abomination upon desolate only comes after the covenant is broken. So is Yahushua going to sit in the temple and do the offerings? You see, they're contradicting themselves. They're shooting themselves in the foot all the time. So he's not, Yahushua is not even going to come near the temple. There's not a scripture that says he's coming back to the temple. To do what? To do what? They want to, the Orthodox Jews, they want to live according to the 613 laws of Moses. Moses couldn't even keep the 613 laws. Because he was disobedient. When Yahweh spoke to him and said he must speak to the rock, that he would bring water forth. He hit the rock. He was disobedient. He couldn't keep the 613 laws. That's why he never went into the promised land. He saw it in the distance from a mountain, but he didn't enter. Now who's going to live the 613 laws? Do you want to tell me that in the period of time, after the covenant is broken, that the Israelites, the whole nation of Israel, they all gonna accept Yahushua as their Redeemer and Savior? There's not a scripture that says it. Instead, the Bible says only the remnant of Israel, one third of the nation, will accept Yahushua as their Redeemer and Savior. The other two thirds are gonna perish in the Great Tribulation at the Battle of Armageddon. That's what the Bible says. Only one third. And it's not because of Jesus or Yeshua who's going to sit in the temple. No. They're not going to sit in the temple. They're going to flee in the desert. In the tribulation, they're going to flee in the desert. Look at Revelation 12. Petra. They're going to flee to Petra where Jaffa would uphold them for 3.5 years. Again, just imagine what a game changer it would be if someone showed up with a plan that gave Israel a new temple on the Temple Mount. You can see why Israel could welcome such a proposal. And the man who to bring it, and as said, they may well even receive him as Messiah. The one who brings it, Israel will receive him as the Messiah. Now, who's going to sit in the temple? You must reach 2 Thessalonians 2, chapter 2 and chapter 4. And you see that he's the son of Satan, the son of destruction, who's going to sit in the temple, the Roman Catholic Pope. Not the Messiah. What is this researcher says? Israel will even accept him as the Messiah. So he's indicating, or the English word is insinuating. He's insinuating that Yeshua is going to sit in the temple. And then they will accept him as Messiah. He doesn't have to sit in the temple. He won't even come back for them. Because Yahweh's going to send 144 men who have not defiled them with women. And that doesn't mean having sex with them. They haven't defiled them. A woman is churches. The figurative speech in Revelation, woman, churches, Babylonian All Mother. It's a Roman Catholic Church. The 144,000, they haven't defiled them with the Babylonian All Mother. The woman, they haven't defiled them with women. It's not having intercourse with women. It's they haven't moved from one church to the Protestant, to Charismats, to Catholics, to the Orthodox Jews. And they are going to be the evangelist who will preach the gospel of salvation to Israel in the Great Tribulation. They're not going to have Yeshua to do it. They're not going to have a Messiah that does it. I just want to think, I'm just thinking of something. If Yeshua has to return to Israel, in Jerusalem, being in a temple, is he again going to ascend into heaven? On what stage? On what stage is he going to ascend into heaven? Like you've been ascended before. You see, it's not going to happen again. He's coming back. He's coming back for the bride. At the end of Revelation 3:22, the time of grace. We are living in the age of grace, or the dispensation of grace. And when grace has abound, then the bride's going to be taken out. The Ruach HaKodesh is going to be taken away with the bride. Then for the second time, Yahushua is going to ascend into heaven with his bride. The next time that he's coming on a white horse. Go read Revelation 17, Revelation 19 verse 11 to 21. When he comes, the next time that he will come after that, after the parousia is for the bride, drawing the bride into heaven. The next time he's going to set foot on Mount Olive, he's coming with a sword to make war. Where's the sword? In his mouth. He's going to speak judgment over the 2/3 of Israel who has not accepted him as the Messiah and the Antichrist will. So it's something to think about. If the third temple theologist, if they have Yeshua in the temple, at what stage do they see him ascending again? Who's he taking with him? Is the Israelites going to take with him? Who are those that's going to flee into the desert? Revelation 12. And the dragon, the Antichrist, will come after her. It's Israel. And she will get a pair of wings like an eagle. Thrown to the throne of Jaffa. That is showing a coming, a rapture, or not a coming, it's a rapture. That's the rapture. That's a figurative speech where Israel, they will be raptured into heaven. One third, the remnant. And the man who brings it and has said that may even receive him as the Messiah. So they will want to receive him as the Messiah. The one that can bring peace to Israel and and all the states and to Jerusalem. They will receive him as the Messiah. Who's sitting in a temple? Who's sitting in there? The Roman Catholic Pope. Who will become the Antichrist? He can't become the Messiah. Now till tomorrow morning, if it's Jehovah's will, Maranatha. Yahshua is coming back again. Hallelujah.